Ayoungman steps out of the courthouse and joins dozens in a healing song as the trial of her son's killer comes to an end. Brandon Giffen was found guilty of manslaughter in the death of 24-year-old Kristian Ayoungman over 2 years ago.
We're going to walk away humbly, loving, kind, caring, the way we taught my son, Kakadusi Kristian Ayoungman. What happened today, yes, we're all disappointed. We expected that highest charge. I left it in the hands of the court.
In March, Brandon's brother, Cody Giffen, was sentenced to 4 years in prison after pleading guilty to manslaughter. According to an agreed statement of facts, Ayoungman sold Cody a pack of cigarettes that wasn't full, prompting a fight outside of a Strathmore, Alberta pub, then to an apartment building. Brandon Giffen came out of that building with a hunting rifle, and that's when Ayoungman and his friends fled in a truck. The Giffens followed them and pulled over. Brandon fired the rifle, striking and killing Ayoungman. His mother says she believes Brandon Giffen should have been charged with murder.
Our justice system failed again today. Big, big time. They are wrong. You take a life, you aim a gun where there's human beings. That's murder.
Giffen's defense lawyer, Derek Jugnauth, says his client is relieved to possibly return to parent his own children.
Yeah, well, there's no question Mr. Giffen is relieved with the verdict from a legal standpoint. But the reality remains of the tragedy that occurred back in March of 2019, and he has to live with that reality the rest of his life, knowing that he took another's life.
But for Melody Ayoungman and her daughter, Kyla Rose, who dances for her brother, some positive change needs to come from this tragedy.
Times need to change. Things need to change. I hope they learn from their decisions from today. We're not here to create riots. Today's different. Look at us being peaceful. That's the way it should be. We're all getting along, all of us here. And that's the way it should be.
Tamara Pimentel, APTN National News, Calgary.